when I look out the window of my studio here, I see old upstate New York buildings full of bricks. I draw big brick buildings all the time. It feels good. I feel like I'm touching the bricks when I draw them. Like it's just like this very tactile sensation going on in my brain. You know, I'm really interested in patterns and textures, and a place like Troy has a lot of patterns and textures in it. A lot of the stories that I've been telling are all set in kind of this specific place. I built this town in one of my books called Saint Forget, and it's a seaside town that exists in some kind of abstract pre-technology area. It's kind of Lovecraftian in that it's New England set, and it's a very foggy place with a lot of sea culture. There's a lot of fishermen. It's like the community is based on fishermen and that sort of economy. There's no technology in my stories because I don't think technology is a fun thing to draw and share an idea. Like something lit by candlelight looks cooler than something lit by a computer monitor. So my stories take place in kind of this sad, desolate world. I think, I don't want to insult upstate New York, but I grew up around here and it's where I choose to come and live. But a lot of the buildings and environments of upstate New York, you can see they were once something that they are not anymore. And sometimes they become new great things, but you can see there's a ghost of an era that was, that inspired beautiful buildings and manufacturing and just a good economy and people coming to work and building stuff. And those skeletons of those buildings are all still there, but the people that made that stuff happen and embodied it, they're gone. And now, you know, artist studios move into there, or, you know, restaurants take over these big manufacturing buildings and turn them into kind of a kitschy, like, aesthetic.